Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Sean V Nice back again with some more Heat Rocking. Today, we're taking a look at the Trab Lab HD77 Bluetooth speaker. Let's get into it. First thing we're going to touch on this marvelous sounding speaker is the build quality. Now with the build quality, you kind of got this hard plastic, right? But that's to kind of make it light, obviously, right? Mesh type speakers, which all of them have plastic buttons. What I think about this Bluetooth speaker is IPX6 splash proof. So meaning like if you got it like a beach, something like that, it can get splashed, but it's not fit for submergence. So don't be one of those people who dump your whole speaker into the water expecting it still to work. It don't work like that. You get a splash, get a little wet, spill a little drink under the table at a party, you cool, but if you just go ahead and just dunk into some water, wrap it up. The next thing I feel about the build quality is just honestly the coloring. For some odd reason, I gotta think about something that's like there's certain aesthetics that make things pop out to me. And one thing that popped out to me was the fact that depending on what's going on with the Bluetooth speaker, it'll change colors. So if you are like turning it off, the ring will turn red. If you got the aux cord plugged into it, it'll be green. And if you're playing your music or your audio through Bluetooth speakers, it'll be blue. Moving right along to the main important feature of a speaker, which you want to know, right? How does it sound and how does it bass? Now, depending on where you are, like it can definitely fill up a small room, maybe like a smaller office. Would I kind of let's take this and replace it for a whole Bluetooth speaker for a whole party? No, but just kind of like for that personal level, it does get the job done. Now, the only thing that I have noticed, and this is more so just a Bluetooth thing. There's like a slight lag if you're watching like a YouTube video. So for example, I was watching the URL battle rap. What happened was when the rapper was, when he was talking, sometimes the words wasn't really aligning with what the speaker was putting out. So that happens every now and then. Heck, it still happens in my car sometimes. That's more so a Bluetooth issue versus speaker issue, but just something to kind of keep in mind. I don't want you guys thinking it's a treble problem. That's more of a Bluetooth software problem. But with that being said, the sound is full. It does sound good. Again, on a scale of 1 to 10, I would probably get a sound like an 8, but for the price point, I'm gonna give it a 10, because for this price point of $80, to get a speaker that sounds that good for $80, I'm not tripping or complaining. And with that sound comes the bass. Now the bass is not heavy, like it's not like super heavy, but it's gonna let you know like, hey, I'm here. It's not a lot of me, but I am here, so hear me roar type of thing. So the bass does sound good on it, and again, for $80, am I expecting like really rich, immersive sound? No, but it does give me it kind of does give you that 360 round sound. It just depends on the type of environment you are in. So if you get like somewhere like with a whole bunch of high ceilings, or it's a big area, not so much, probably won't give it to you like the way you want it. But if you are just pretty much in your room or in a bathroom, I would definitely recommend you take this in a bathroom, which you kind of have your own tools jamming. And yes, it would definitely fill that bathroom up with more than enough noise. And just for your own personal view, here's a demonstration. So cute, I get some in the mouth, I feel all grills, heat in the car, that smells on wheels. Woo! I was born a flex, yes. Diamonds on my neck. So bad, it's all real, I ride in cause some big tall hills, big fat checks, big large bills, run out flip like 10 car wheels, cold. Next, now, just like any other Bluetooth speaker, it does do calls. Now, as the call quality, just from my end and from the other person's end, they said it was good, like, it wasn't like mind blowing or anything like that, but it's still crystal clear. You can hear everything the person's saying. They can hear what I'm saying. From a distance wise, this is just me. I wouldn't be somewhere like in the living room and expecting a speaker to hit me like in my office area, something like that. No, but it does hit me at least at a pretty good distance. Like it depends on how your voice carries. Again, you really can't blame that on like software, but if you have a voice that just carries, period, then this speaker would definitely be fine for calls. So especially if you're cooking and you had your music playing, you had a call come through, this speaker definitely can handle that with no problem at all. So now with all that being said, after we discussed the build quality, sound quality, I know the number one question is gonna say, yo Sean, is it worth $80? I mean, my answer to that is yes, it's definitely worth $80. Are there other options that you can definitely look at? Yes, but for the price point of where TrabLab stands at, I think TrabLab is really setting itself apart from a lot of manufacturers when it comes to these price points, right? They kind of like the OnePlus of the audio department, right? Because even with the headphones, their Bluetooth speakers and stuff like that, they are saying, hey, we can provide this same level of quality as all these other speakers that cost between $200 to $300, even with headphones, and still give you that same quality at a much lower price point. So there may be some sacrifice you may have to take in the aesthetics department or maybe build, but to me, for what you're still getting, like for what you're buying the product for, TrabLab over delivers that, especially the price point they give. So with that being said, man, I'll make sure I link this product down in the description below. It's your boy Sean Benice, and I'm out. Deuces.